Mem, it's a fairly new note-taking application. In this video, I wanted to show you how I'm using it and a few of the different ways, including page anchors, journal, and a bit of insight around the flows experience in it that get me around my week. So let's dive into today's video. If you are new here to keep productive, welcome. Please do hit subscribe and join us for another video. It'd be great to have you, and I'd love your thoughts below how maybe I can improve my Mem usage in this video. So here we have Mem in front of me, and collectively I've only made just over 300 Mems. And this isn't actually my account, because I wanted to demonstrate what I'm talking about in terms of creating pages with you, just to visually demonstrate it, but also because I do a lot of personal journaling in Mem. So obviously I don't want to share it in full capacity, but I'm going to build exactly what I have in a simple anchor page setups and journal in this video. So you can see here that Mem is structurally pretty similar to a lot of note-taking applications, but from the start you have this area called timeline. One thing I really like about timeline, especially for journaling, is it captures when you begin a note and when you finish a note. And I quite like that, because over a time period, you can see this timeline of when you've not only created a note, but when you've viewed a note too. So you get this really nice like timeline on the right-hand side, sort of like Google Photos approach to notes, which is really nice. Now, as you can see here, this is an example of a note and a mem. A mem is very much a simple note. And when you go and create a mem, you have to create a header to start and start typing away. And there's not really a hideous amount you can do with the multimedia side as much as you would in, say, an app like Notion or Evernote. However, you can add things like templates, attach files, they've recently added a PDF ability, images, and date entry too. Now, let me show you first off how I create something I call anchor pages. Now, anchor pages are basically these pages that are like the core foundation of some of the setups I have. So one of them, as a good example, is my mortgage balance, because I like to keep updated with how I'm sort of going in with each month and things like that, how many overpayments I'm potentially trying to make, or underpayments, etc. And you can see here that it's very simply structured like this. I put an emoji in front of it with the title of the page. And what I'll do is, if I have an update about that, I will simply do type in today, and I will add the balance, say, you know, here. And you can see there that it comes up like this. And it's quite nice, because I can get this running tally, almost like a diary ongoing, of how I'm making progress on this, and potentially be able to reference it for future. Now, I do this with actually a few different areas. So the other thing I do it for is, let me just go and create it. So I do this for weight, and very simply, all I do is essentially just put today's date and add my weight to it. Maybe that, for example, and I'll just keep a tally of it. And I do this with a few different categories, like how much is in my pension, how much is in my mortgage, my weight, and it just gives me an idea of sort of collectively how I'm working on things and progressing. And I quite like having that, actually. It's sort of like connected with my journaling, which I'll talk about later. Now, the other way that I sort of combine this ongoing tallying methodology in a simple text format is actually by doing goals. So what I would do is I will have a goals page that have a goals for the year in the different categories like health, family, work, and personal life maybe, or something like this as just a breakdown. So here's a good example of this. And what I'll do is I'll link any of the relevant areas that I see fit. Like I could be like, here's a goal like reduce by X amount on, and then add mortgage balance, so that they begin to build relationships with them. But what I do is I actually have down here is 22 goals, and then I have a page called, say, June 2022 goals. And I'll create these every single month. And what I'll do is I'll open them up on the right-hand side, make the title nice and big. And what I'll do is at the top, I'll write so far, and I have a template for this in which I'll show you near the end of this video. And I also have down the below, goals, health, work, family, just as a sort of rough sketch. And then I'll basically just add like, do one press up. I'll add these breakdown of goals here. And I'll give this one a heading 3 and this one a heading 3, but I normally just save them time in the template. And what I noticed I was doing last year was every year I have done sort of like an annual review type of thing where I've been able to look back and sort of review what I did month to month, at least successes. But what I've started doing this year is actually doing this per month. So anytime I get some form of success in the month, whether that is Otto learning to read a new book or him learning a new word, all the way to a success in launching something or a success on the channel, for example, I will just log it in here and it'll be as simple as Otto learnt new word or and maybe like secured new sponsor. And then I'll link the page, Bento say, etc., etc. So I have what I believe ongoing to be a tally of successes and losses as well. And this actually helps me when it comes to the journaling side of stuff. And let me show you what I mean by that. So for example, I know I wouldn't do this typically on the goal side. Actually, let's do this properly. Let's say I'm writing a journal for a week review, and I'll only tend to do a week review, which is something that is just normally on a Thursday, and I'll put today's date, for example. So what I'll do is I'll make a simple title like, how did this week go? And I won't do this manually, I'll do this using the flow ability, which I'll show you near the end of this video, and I'll say, thoughts on next week, and then I'll go to priorities. So what I'll do is I'll write a few musings about how this week has gone, the last week, and I'll do some thoughts on next week. But at the same time, at the top, and I'll unlink it because I don't necessarily need it to be there, I'll link my June goals, because say that's the month I have. And I'll keep my June goals to the side so that every week and I'm like, okay, let me review last week. I write down what I reviewed last week and then I'll pick up things and I'll go, oh yeah, I did this, or oh yeah, I did that, or I didn't do well at this, I didn't do well at that. And I'll potentially add this to the so far area, which is really, really helpful. And what I'll also do is down the bottom here, I will link, I haven't created it yet because this is a dummy account. I'll create the same for July 2022 goals, and I'll write next. Then when I go back to the collective goals, so let me just find that page, long-term goals, and I open it up, I can be like, okay, I can see my June goals here, which is ideal, and I'll just open it up again. I can go to and create. There we go. And I can begin to connect up the dots here and be able to see an ongoing tally of my goals as they run along. If I have a journal that I'm, say, writing about that is starting a new month, it gives me the opportunity to start a new month. So that's how I go about sort of structuring my week review. I do last week, I do next week, and I do priorities. But what's nice about the way that I do my sort of week review is sometimes if I'm in a position where I want a little bit of clarity about how I'm like planning stuff, What I would do is it sounds weird, but I'll talk to myself as I'm writing my week review. So for example, I'd be like, okay, what are the priorities this week? Launch Bento for Android, say. I'll be like, okay, so this is going well. Right now, I'm feeling a little anxious about it. I'm just trying to give you what it actually is, a bit like that. And then I'd be like, let me quickly check what the results were for pre-launch registrations. Then what I'll do is I'll actually go and do that, and then I'll come back and start typing. And I don't know whether it was Thiago Forte who said to me that this is a type of journaling that is used in, I don't know whether he said it's CBT or something of a similar kind, and it's like a guided journaling where you're thinking out what you're doing at the same time as you're activating it. And actually, it's quite mindful because we rarely do that when we're doing a task. It's like having an internal monologue as you're trying to complete a task. And it does keep you on task quite effectively. So I do find these week reviews to be quite good in terms of looking at priorities as well, but also keeping updated with that annual review and keeping an eye on sort of goals. But what is nice is when I grab time to look at my long-term goals, I just swap that out. And then what I'll do is I'll open up the latest month's goals, or let's say for July, and I'll correlate them. I'll be like, okay, so how is work going? What do I need to do this month as a 30-day window to launch Bento, to reach 250 and keep productive, etc., etc. And what it helps me to do is correlate what are the long-term goals and how do I make smaller movements in this month to work towards those goals. So I really like the way that you can split mems up in terms of breaking them down. So as I said, I use Flows a lot. Flows basically has a bunch of features, including a lot of capture functionality. But one of the things that I use most is the templates. So let's say I'm trying to replicate a monthly goals one. And that's just to save me time at the end of the year. Not the end of the year, every time I create those monthly goals areas. So I could, for example, say, okay, let's call this one month goals 2022. And then I can replace this when it's relevant, of course. And then below I can be like, okay, so far this month, and I can put some nice emoji on it, etc. And I could start us off with a bullet point. So you can start to see that this is actually saving me time when it comes to doing the actual thing. And then I could be like, okay, goals for this month, and already create the structure that I need. And then create template. Okay, so this is where the magic happens. If I'm in this area, for example, and I am like, okay, I'll press slash command and I'll type in monthly goals template, boom, done. And I can be like July goals 2022. Actually, I structured the title a little bit differently. I got goals to it like that. So you can start to see how easy the template side of stuff is. And the same goes to the weekly review side of stuff. So I might be like, okay, go back to flows, go to templates, go to, actually I had a weekly review template there. This is my demo account, as you can see, and I can be like, boom, and just add some nice emojis. So you start to get the idea of how I go about structuring my account. Now you're probably wondering, what does this look like week to week? How often do you use it? And things like that. So when I'm trying to get a bit of clarity midweek, what I'll tend to do is I'll grab this, and I'll sit down and I'll journal through a week review. So that's normally on a Thursday and it takes me about 20 minutes. This is my carrot cake and coffee shop trip. So I'll try and get a nice cake combined with getting this out and working on it, which is really nice. The other thing that I'll try and do is during the week, maybe when I'm doing, say, something related to, I press Command K, I'll go to like, okay, pension portfolio. Then I can do these. So when it's specifically time, I can go in and log this. When I weigh myself, I'll go in and log this. And I find it actually to be a really nice location to do stuff like that. Then when I have a success, I'm like, okay, July 2022 goals, and I'll go and I'll log, you know, I ran 5K under 20, 30 minutes. You know, like I'll try and keep that log going. And one of the things that I'll do as well to sort of emphasize something inside of a log, I will just highlight it in bold. And it's really, really simple. I moved away from Notion a long time ago, probably about 2 years ago. Well, I guess I found my productivity system to be a lot more simple than I was making it. The way that I tend to do productivity stuff is like, I was adding databases and I felt like I don't need databases for it to work. And I found a pretty robust plain text system that I found to be like bubbly and useful. And some of the more recent PDF abilities that they've been working on and email is quite nice and it's quite speedy. So I've shown you in this video about anchor pages, journaling and how I do it, and flows and how that weaves into all of them. And that's pretty much how I use Mem at the moment. Like all of these new note-taking applications, it's a bit of a preview of what is going to be coming, I guess. I'm just going to continue to extend how I'm using it and see where my limits are, whether I need to fine-tune things or whether I need to improve them. But hopefully that gave you a bit of an insight into how I'm using it for a day. So folks, hopefully you found this video useful. If you're new to Keep Productive or you're interested in checking out more videos about Mem, you can subscribe to us below. We do have a getting started guide to Mem if you fancy checking it out. It'll be linked in the cards above or in the description below. But a big, big thank you for stopping by here on Keep Productive, and we look forward to helping you and educate you more about productivity tools and resources. Thank you very much, folks, and I'll see you all very, very soon. Cheerio.